Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today's August 11, 2011. Oh, 8/11/11 at 3:16 p.m. Right? Okay, I gotta make this quick video because I think it's very important that I make it. Right? In this video, right, it's called "Attack on USA and England: Financial Armageddon, 9/11, Japan, Bush, Clinton, Rothschild." The video was released in what, March 16, 2011. Anyway, in this video, right, people, someone sent me a message. He says, he's called Allo717. His question was, what is your idea on Christianity and Christ? Is Jesus, Isa, Jesus, peace be unto you? Okay, that was his question, right? And my reply was, this video may answer your question, peace be unto you, not Jesus. Why would you, a man, wish Jesus peace when there is war on earth? No, my friend, send peace to earth, not heaven. Here's a link, one love. And I sent him a video, right? I don't remember which video I sent him. It must have been the, anyway. The point being, right, people, he sent me, I just got a reply message from him that says, it says, the term Muslim is only a term in another language. When translated into the English language, you'll get the definition, one who submit their will to one God. Do you think the Muslim prophet would pray to two or more gods? This would definitely be foolish to think. Therefore, he is called Muslim to a Christian, Arab, Jewish, Arab, and Islamic Arab. It's just a word. He was Muslim and one of Islam's greatest prophet of God, being one message with him. Pray to the one God. That is not difficult. So I guess he's talking about Jesus Christ, right? Now, I'm about to take this outside because I think it's very important, because I'm telling people, my friend, I'm not disrespecting you, not disrespecting your faith, but I'm going to tell you right now, it's an idiotic thing to believe in any unseen God that he's so egoistic, right? But yet he cannot show his face. You know what I'm saying? He's supposed to be this great and mighty God, but he cannot show his face. He's hiding. But you see my God right there? He's showing his face. So people, the point being, right? Of all the gods, ever since the beginning of time, right? Ever since man opened his eyes, right? Of all the gods, look it up. Of all the gods ever worshipped by man, of all of them, right? There's only one God that have never died. One God that don't need nobody to give it honor. One God that don't need nobody to praise it. Ah, shut up! Shut up! But man. Train the dogs out from the devil, Rothschild. Every time I'm talking, the dogs always barking to disturb me. Man, Rothschild dogs. Anyway, like I was saying, there's only one God, people, that ever exists that doesn't need anyone to acknowledge it, anyone to recognize it. If no one mentions Jesus Christ, he doesn't exist. If no one mentions Allah, he don't exist. No one mentions Muhammad, he doesn't exist. Krishna, Buddha, Jesus Christ, any one of them, if no one doesn't mention them, they do not exist. Just like Paul said, if Christ didn't die and rise from the dead, then that means your faith is in vain. Okay? Well, basically what he's saying, if you don't believe that crap, if you don't believe that Christ really died and rise, you really died for your sin and rise, then your faith is in vain. Okay? So the point being, you gotta believe that for Christ to be real. But you see that God right there? Nobody needs to acknowledge him. No one needs to recognize him for him to exist. So people, the point I want you to make, right? Let me give you a riddle. Which God that ever exists? I already told you anyway, but I'm gonna say it anyway. There's only one God that exists that make you. You have no choice.
no choice but to worship it. None. And respect it and honor it. You have no freaking choice. And that is the sun, because people, if you walk into a building, right, and the sun is bright and shining in your face, you have no choice but to bow. Which one of you can walk out of the darkness into the light without any dark glasses or anything? Which one of you can walk out into the light when the sun is shining in its strength? Which one of you can walk outside and you don't have to bow? You have to. You cannot look into the sun. You cannot look into the sun. You have to bow. You have to salute. One of the two. You gotta either bow your head or you gotta salute. Why do you think Hitler and all them other people in history, why do you think they always salute? Why do you think soldiers, armies, why do you think they always salute? Why do you think they put their hand over their forehead to shield their eyes and salute? They salute in the sun because you cannot look into the sun. If you look into the sun, you're gonna be blinded. So at least back then when the sun was very bright, because back then the sun was brighter. I say shut up! People, I'm sorry, but for some reason, when every time I try to make a video, the dogs don't keep barking. They don't say nothing when I'm silent. But as soon as I try to make something, they make noise. That's why I know dogs and Rothschild are connected, yo. Dogs are connected to Rothschild. I don't care what nobody say. I don't care how much y'all love dogs, okay? Alright, I don't care. Why do I have them? My business. You don't even have to accept them always barking. I don't like barking dogs. That's why I hate a dog that keep barking for nothing. I hate it. Anyway, like I was saying, people, back to the subject, right? The only God that ever exists that forces man to worship it, he don't force you to. It's a voluntary thing, is the sun. You cannot look into the sun without bowing or saluting. And if you bow, it means you cannot look into it. If you salute, it means you cannot look into it. Remember some place in the Bible where it says, no man can look into the face of God or he'll die? Okay, there you go. Okay? And you don't mean literally die, it means that you could be blinded by looking into God. So people, what I'm trying to say to you, like Muhammad, Jehovah, Allah, Buddha, all them gods, that's why they are dead gods, okay? They need you. People, I don't understand it. Mankind. Can you imagine God needs you? You freaking flesh and blood. You could die any minute. And God needs you to recognize it. People, I see people when they're talking, when I talk about Jesus Christ, they want to disrespect me and curse me out. Some of them would kill me if they want to. You want to kill me for speaking bad about Jesus Christ? What kind of fucking God is that he needs you to defend him? Huh? What kind of God is that he needs you to defend him? He ain't no freaking God. He's dead just like the paper that he wrote him on. Okay? If you gotta defend your God, he's dead just like the paper that you wrote him on. Okay? You see this God right here? He don't need a defense. He don't need nobody to come to his rescue. But your Jesus Christ though, your Allah though, your Jehovah though, your Muhammad though, all of them dead gods they though, they need to come to the defense. Not this one. Okay? I'm not disrespecting anybody. I'm speaking about Muhammad. You're not Muhammad. It's a name. You have never freaking seen Muhammad. You have never seen him. You have never seen Jesus Christ. You see me. But yet you'll quickly cut me down in a heartbeat. You'll quickly murder me over a freaking name that you've never seen or known. A name that somebody created. And you talk about these religious people as if you know them and they came to you and spoke to you. Show me some freaking proof. They're not real. They exist only in your damn imagination. Okay? Even if they were real, they're dead and gone. We can't stop for the freaking living. Okay? And stop taking care of the dead. The dead don't need you. The living is who need you. Okay, so if you wanna get pissed off at me, come on. Okay? I don't give a damn. You cannot do nothing. I don't know fear you. You see why fear? Him right there. That's the master. God will need nobody to say he's alive. One love for those who respect knowledge. Later.